These are consecutive integer word problems, and the way you can tell they're consecutive integer problems is they say consecutive integers. And the way you start them is to write out what an example of what they're asking for would be. So three consecutive positive integers would be 1, 2, 3. Those are consecutive positive integers. All right, and once we have these, you can now see what the relationship is. So if you mark the first one as x, that's our first integer, then all we have to do is find out how much we have to add to the first to make the second. And the difference between 1 and 2 is a 1. So that means that would be x plus 1. That's our second integer. And how to get from 1 to 3, you'd have to add 2. So now we have a nice little formula that tells us how to create our integers. So if you pick any number for the first one, this is just an example, 7. Then 7 plus 1 would be 8, and 7 plus 2 would be 9. And see, we have 7, 8, 9 consecutive integers. So we have our formula. So anytime they say find three consecutive integers, there's your formula. X, x plus 1, x plus 2. Now the next is pretty quick. It says they have a sum of 36. So if you place them in there, there you go. That's our 36. And that's our equation we can solve. So we have x plus 1 plus x plus 2. And that has to equal 36. So that's 3 x's plus 3 equals 36. And just keep solving. So our three consecutive integers are 11. And add 1 and add 2. 11, 12, 13. How do we know they're correct? Well, they're consecutive integers, so that's the first part. It checks out. They just have to add up to 36. So that would be 36. Check. So we know we're 100% correct. Let's try another one. So this one's a little different. It says the sum of three consecutive odd integers. So three consecutive odd integers would be 1, but not 2, 3, not 4, 5. They're consecutive, but they're odd. You could also have 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, just consecutive odd. And if you look at the relationship, first one's x. To get from 1 to 3, you have to add 2. And to get to 1 to 5, you have to add 4. It's a difference of 4. So if you notice, it's x plus 2, x plus 4. The nice thing is if it says consecutive odd or even, this is what you always will use. They always will have that same difference. Watch, plug in 11. 11 plus 2 is 13. 11 plus 4 is 15. 11, 13, 15. Works every time. There it is. So now, what does it say there's a relationship between these three quantities? It says they have a sum that is 57. So x plus 2, x plus 4 is 57. Add them up. 3 x's plus 6 equals 57. So 17 is our first odd. So it's 17, add 2 is 19, add 4 is 21. So notice it's always a difference of 2 each time. It's the same with even. So if this had said the sum of three consecutive even integers is, and given a different number, because this one only works for the odd, then you would be able to solve it and find your three even. So let's see if you could try one. There it is. This is a little bit more different, but see if you can at least set up what your first two integers would be. And then I will help you with the second part. So all I want you to do is part A. Hit pause and try part A. So this is what you should have gotten. We're looking for two consecutive even integers. And the same format for even and odd, it's x, x plus 2. So if it had said three consecutive even, it'd be x, x plus 2, x plus 4. If it said four consecutive even, it'd be x, x plus 2, x plus 4, x plus 6. Four consecutive odd, same exact thing. Now the relationship is this translation right here, and I've already written it down here to allow us to translate it. It says such that 6 times the first is x, equals 3 times the second, and the second is x plus 2, and that's it. You just translate it. 6 times first equals 3 times second. So we get 6x equals 3 times x plus 2, and then solve it. So we get 3x's plus 6. Put the x's on one side. And then now we can divide. And that's our first consecutive even. So the answer would be 2 and 4. And how do we know we're correct? Let's answer it. It says 6 times the first equals 3 times the second. Is that true? Yes, it is. All right. Let's see if you can do this one. If you can do this one, and don't forget to review the answer like I forgot to do on number 2. But write out your 3 consecutive even integer formulas. Remember, it's x, x plus 2, x plus 4. And then see if you can translate it, solve it, and then check your answer. Hit pause now and try it. All right, and this is what you should have had for your setup. So since you see consecutive even integers, these should be your first 3. Because they're even. Even or odd, same setup. And then we just have to translate it, so I like to rewrite the sentence. And it's 3 times the smallest, would be x, because that's the first one, is equals 2 more than twice, and then whenever we substitute, you want to place it in a parenthesis. And now you can just solve it, and then write your answers, 10, 12, and 14, and then make sure they work. And so how do you know they work? Let's find out what it says. It says 3 times the smallest must equal 2 more than twice the larger. So that's 30. 2 plus 20. Oops, 8. And that's 30. And there you go. All checks out. Thanks.